Hello, hello, the people are here. So this is a video that I want to put out in order to awaken people, especially those who want to get into business in the Kenyan market. I was able to enter into some businesses across East Africa, especially in Kenya and Uganda. And this is what I learned about the Kenyan market all the way from the coast. You should understand that the major movers of capital in the Kenyan market or major companies are majorly involved and deeply involved in money laundering schemes with the government. For if you understand how governments work and how economies work, is that the government is the biggest source of businesses for companies. And if you understand the nature of Kenya and how it operates, you should know that for Kenyans or us as Kenyans, if you look at our system of government, it is not stable, but it's very corrupt. So being corrupt in nature, also the businesses that function or get their tenders from government, they tend to be very corrupt and also to launder these monies. And this, I'll try to explain to you how Kenya found itself in this place. I'll start by telling you that, as you know, Kenya is a major transit point, especially the Northern Corridor. It's a major transit point for East Africa and also the eastern part of Congo. For we use our resources and also our transport sector to sell or to export a lot of goods produced. So from our airports, JKIA to the port, and also our highways, we transport a lot of goods. And through these goods, we are able to fund the works of our government and also business people. Now, this is what I want to tell you. The minerals that you hear that they come from Congo, majority of them pass through Kenya. That's a starting point. There is also a drug route of a shipment of drugs that comes through Pakistan all the way to the coast, and also from Iran and those Middle Eastern countries. It comes to the coast to the East drug money. There's also transnational crimes and international money that comes to be laundered in the Kenyan economy, and also the aid money and multilateral loans. They are laundered through our economy. And the way they launder these loans is that Kenya is given a loan, but the loan actually does not come to Kenya. They may bring half the money or not even bring the money, but this money is deposited in foreign accounts. But our leaders are used as conduits or puppets to push an agenda and say that the loans came into Kenya and they were used to service the Kenyan economy, which is a lie. No money comes here. The money remains in those countries. Another point of washing money is through bars, the entertainment joints, and also through festivals. The major festivals that you hear, they are conduits of money laundering. Why? In festivals, there is a lot of cash rich. It's a type of cash rich business. In Kenya, major cash rich businesses are used as conduits of laundering money. So festivals, what happens is the money that is given by the revelers who go to these entertainment joints and also festivals, when the money is going to be banked, they bring other sources of cash, which is mixed in with the funds which they go to deposit. And when they go and take this money to the bank, they later send to the accounts that they are given. And what is used as an explanation is to say that services were offered to this festival, so we are paying for these services. And that's how they are able to push money that was outside the system into the system as a form of clean money that was used to pay for an event that was happening or for supplying goods to maybe an entertainment joint. Another example is the petrol stations that you see popping up in every town and major city. They are major points of laundering money because they are cash-rich businesses. So these monies which are taken to be deposited are also laundered through this method. Another major conduit which is mostly used by drug runners and major corruption scandals is the supermarket chains or supermarket sector. As you've known, in Kenya, many supermarkets have collapsed. Why? Every supermarket comes with different dispensations. When new leaders come, the supermarkets or businesses tend to collapse because the source that or the money that was used to sustain these supermarkets always comes to an end and the supermarket chain collapses. So this is what happens when money is taken to supermarkets, when the supermarket is going to deposit maybe the day's earning. Money is brought and also put into the banking system. And when they want to send this money to the said account of the money launderer, they always pay a cut. And after they pay a cut, this money is written as a form of payment for goods supplies into this supermarket chain, which actually is not the main point. Another type is, and this one you should know that, is the companies that you find supplying fast moving goods in the Kenyan market. For example, things like milk. Okay? Those who supply milk, this is a fast moving good and it moves every day. And when they supply it, is that they mix in with the money of the day's earnings, and they say that this is money that was used to supply certain types of goods. Also, if you have seen every major family in Kenya, or the richest families, they own a bank. I don't want to say the names, but they always own banks. And the Kenyan system has made it easy for them to pass the money through their banking systems. You can imagine in Kenya, the same guys who are in government also own banks. Go and do your own investigation. I'll not say this because I don't want to be sued, but they actually own their own banks, and these banks is where they are able to pass their money as clean money through their businesses without raising a lot of eyebrows. Another form of money laundering that is major is that they use drug money. And this drug money is laundered through the system of supermarkets. Yeah, you should go and investigate, like the case of Nakumat, how Nakumat came to fail. Nakumat was used to clean and clear drug money in conjunction with Chatham House Bank, which collapsed, and Imperial Bank was also used to secure loans which were not secured, which were later laundered through Dubai. So the chain of money that launders money through the Kenyan system also uses the Dubai and Mauritius to hide a lot of the process of crime that come from Kenya. And these two jurisdictions, especially Mauritius, have signed like taxation agreements with Kenya, where there is no double taxation for any money that is deposited in either jurisdiction. So you should understand that in the Kenyan system, for you to function as a business, do not buy the hype of how businesses are expanding and growing. You should look behind the curtains and know that majority of businesses in Kenya, for example, the businesses that open in major malls or other businesses, you hear that rent is around 700,000 per month. Just rent, and you wonder what type of business is this gang doing to raise this type of money. What is actually happening is that the business is opened to show that it is in a place with a lot of foot traffic and a lot of business. But actually, the business goes to deposit money, and the sources of this money is not known. So this is how money is looted and laundered in the Kenyan economy. So what we have in Kenya is actually not an economy, but it's a bandit or mafia economy. And in order for us to deliver Kenya, we have also to deliver our economy, which is under a lot of siege. So you should understand this, and thank you for listening to this monologue that I was broadcasting. But this is the names I want you to go investigate. Go and investigate the collapse of Uchumi Supermarket, of Tuskys, of Nakumat, of Chatham House Bank, and actually even auditors died, of Imperial Bank, and other businesses that are registered in the stock market, and how they launder money from every government, parastatal, and institution. So thank you.